I would like to invite to the stage my dear partner for the last 5 years at least, Dirk Pieper. He established actually Elvira Angel and invited me to join him. And since then we are happily ever after, starting with tax consulting, and after that we developed to business consulting, and with our colleagues, the lawyers and the other experts in marketing and business, we managed to give together, I think, a good service for clients from Israel to Germany and the opposite way. Elvira Angel specialized only in German, Israel-Germany relationship, and Dick is our specialist in tax consulting in both ways, and I think that I'll leave the stage to Dirk.
Ophia, thank you very much. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First, let me begin by thanking you for joining our conference. I hope that you already got some useful information for your business this morning. Now I'm here to present you some basic information about investment incentives that are offered for your market entry in Germany. Investments in Germany can be supported by public funding independently whether the investor comes from Germany or from Israel. The decisive factor is that your investment will be done by a business establishment in Israel. A business establishment could be, in this meaning, a German company or also a branch of your Israeli company that is registered in the German Register of Companies. Background of this requirement is that most of the incentive programs, except programs for supporting research and development investments, are aiming for creation of long-term jobs in Germany. Therefore, it is necessary to run a business unit, not only a permanent establishment, for example, according to tax law. More general criteria for investment incentives are the size of the parent company, the site of the planned investment, its line and scope of business. Many incentives are supporting investments that will provide new jobs and will strengthen the economic structure and development of some regions in Germany. The funds for incentive programs in Germany are provided by the German government, the governments of the federal states in Germany, and also by the European Union. Most of the subsidies financed by the European Union are executed by delegation to each EU member state government, so also to the German government. Altogether, there are numerous incentive programs existing in Germany with a lot of special criteria. For giving some structure in this matter, we can separate incentives in investment incentives on one side and operational incentives on the other side, like you can see on the slide. This differentiation is also in the meaning of timing. Investment incentives include several measures to reimburse investment costs at the beginning of the investment process. The operational incentives take effect after the investment has been realized. Therefore, both incentives also can be combined. Now talking about investment incentives, we can subdivide investment incentives into direct subsidies, interest reduced loans, and public loan guarantees. Direct subsidies in the form of non-repayable cash payments are the main instrument of investment incentives. One major program is the GRW program. GRW is standing for, in German language, Gemeinschaftsaufgabe zur Verbesserung der regionalen Wirtschaftsstruktur. That can be translated directly into English as Joint Agreement for the Improvement of Regional Economic Structure, GRW. This program was initiated in order to support the economic development mainly in the new federal states in eastern Germany, but it is also available throughout Germany. I will come back to the GRW program with some more details later on. In addition to this program, there are a lot of other programs existing, offering direct subsidies financed by the federal states or by other regional organizations. Other incentives for investments are, for example, interest-reduced loans by public banks, so-called development banks. The major bank on the national level is the KfW Bank, the development bank of the Federal Republic of Germany. In addition to KfW Bank, we also have development banks on the state level, which are providing special loan programs for investments in the state region. Later on, I will also come back to the loan program of KfW Bank. The financing incentives are completed by public loan guarantees. These financial instruments are offered, for example, in cases in which a new company has difficulties to secure financing by a private bank. Target of the instrument is to enable financing by a private bank and also to decrease the interest rate of the loan. Once the investment has been realized, the new business could be supported by operational incentives. Here we have two main instruments: human resources incentives, that means labor-related incentives, and R&D incentives. Labor-related incentives offer several opportunities of reducing operational costs, especially personal expenses. They are offered by the German Federal Employment Agency and the German Federal States. The measures of labor-related incentives include recruitment support by helping companies to find the right staff, training support for prospective new employees, or as training on the job, and also wage subsidies. Wage subsidies are offered when companies are hiring long-term unemployed persons. In these cases, employers can get subsidies up to 50% of wage costs, including social security costs, for a period up to 12 months, 1 year. These subsidies can be raised up to 70% if the unemployed persons are older or have disabilities. All labor-related incentives are available throughout Germany, independently from company size or site of investment. These incentives are managed by the local job centers and their services are free of charge. Now coming to research and development incentives. Research and development is considered here as part of the operational activity of a company. R&D is very important for the future development of a company, and therefore there are many programs existing offering R&D subsidies, interest-reduced loans for R&D projects, or special partnership programs. R&D subsidies are financed by the European Union, the German government, and the government of the federal states in Germany. Generally, the R&D incentives are aiming to support personal expenses of R&D projects. Other costs, like purchase of equipment, for example, can also be eligible if these costs are clearly and directly assigned to a special R&D project. I think Grisha today morning already talked about the program Horizon 2020. Actually, the EU has started a new framework program. This is a program, Horizon 2020, for supporting research and innovation. It was finally enacted 1 month ago by the European Council, and meanwhile there has been presented first calls for projects. One special incentive program issued by the German government is the Central Innovation Program for Small and Middle-Sized Companies, called ZIM. This funding program is supporting companies with business operations in Germany that want to develop new or improve existing products. Finally, each German state has R&D incentive programs designed for specific industry clusters and also programs without any specific technological focus. As alternative to R&D subsidies, there are development loans provided by different governmental programs. For example, the ERP Innovation Program that offers interest-reduced loans for financing up to 100% of the eligible investment costs of R&D measures, or the introduction of new products by small and middle-sized companies. These special loans are offered by the already mentioned KfW Bank, the development bank on the national level. In addition to subsidies and development loans, it is possible to establish public silent partnerships for financing R&D activity. These partnerships are offered also by KfW Bank and in addition also by venture capital companies of the federal states in Germany. Before coming back to some details concerning the GRW program and the interest-reduced loans of the KfW Bank, I want to describe some important issues how to use incentive programs in the investment process. Investment always starts with an idea and then followed by a business plan. The research and evaluation of available incentive programs should always be part of the business planning, also because incentives will have influence on financing the investment. Regarding use of incentives, the planning phase has to consider especially the size of the company and location for the investment, because these criteria are fundamentally for finding out about possible incentive solutions. For most incentive programs, the German company or business unit in Germany must be fully established. It is crucial for the successful promotion of investments that in almost every incentive program it is not allowed to start with the business activity of the investment project before submitting the official application. There are some programs in which you can start with the project after submitting the application at your own risk, and also other programs that need your application 6 weeks before starting with the project. But in any case, it is recommended to find out exactly about this question depending on the special requirements of the incentive program. To be on the safe side, you can start with the project after getting the official approval letter. The time required for preparing an application depends on the kind of investment and on the available information about the incentive program. The time of 4 to 8 weeks is not unusual. After filing the application, it could need 6 up to 12 weeks more to receive the approval letter. The implementation of subsidies will be usually performed by payments for a specific period of time. It's important to run an up-to-date bookkeeping system for your German company or business establishment, because regarding the clearing of subsidies with the funding organization, that will be done monthly, quarterly, or yearly, it will be necessary to use actual bookkeeping data for setting up relevant project accounting. Now, before coming to the end, I want to come back to some details of investment incentives that I already mentioned at the beginning, GRW subsidies and KfW loans. The GRW program is one of the major programs in Germany. This program has been, as already told, initiated in order to support the economic development, mainly in Eastern Germany, but also throughout Germany. The program is offering non-repayable subsidies for investment costs, usually in the form of cash payments. Depending on the size of your company and the investment region in Germany, the incentive rates vary from 20% to 50% for small companies, 10% to 40% for medium-sized companies, and 15% to 30% for large companies. Actually, these incentive rates will be modified still this year, because a new regulation of GRW program is actually in progress. The expected new incentive rates for the time starting in July this year are at a maximum level of up to 25% or 35%, as shown on the slide. the criteria of the company size refer to the official European Union-wide classification system that is shown on the next slide. According to this system, for example, a small company has less than 50 employees, and in addition, either the annual turnover or the annual balance sheet total is less than 10 million euro. A medium-sized company has less than 250 employees, and either an annual turnover of less than 50 million euro or an annual balance sheet total of less than 43 million euro. The GRW program is connected with some special requirements that are applying independently from the investment region. First of all, the investment project must create long-term jobs. The subsidies are limited to a maximum amount of euro 500,000 per new job created. Second, the subsidized fixed assets must remain at the investment location for at least 5 years. Eligible costs are the purchase or production costs of certain tangible assets, but the cost for the purchase of real estate, intangible assets, vehicles, and other is non-eligible. Furthermore, each federal state is free to determine individual ceilings for the incentive rates of its regions. Altogether, we have more than 100 regions in Germany. This also shows that the evaluation of possible investment locations as part of the planning phase is very important. Now I want to come to some details of KfW loans, interest reduced loans as part of investment incentives. KfW Bank is a development bank on the national level, and it offers loans with interest rates below the current market value and in combination with attractive maturity periods. The interest rates are actually varying from 1% to 7% depending on risk evaluation. Loan maturities are offered up to 5 years in case of working capital loans and up to 10 years for investment loans. In case of purchase of business real estate or companies, the maturity period can be set up to 20 years. KfW loans are an offer for small and medium-sized companies within the first 3 years after start-up of the business activity. The loan amount can finance up to 100% of the investment amount and is limited to a maximum of 10 million euro. The application for these loans from KfW Bank is made via the private bank of the investor in Germany. Very often, the KfW loans are used as special component of the whole financing package of the private bank. Altogether, Germany offers a big number of incentive programs available for Israeli investors. These incentive programs have got a lot of special criteria depending on kind and size of investment. The challenge is to find the right and most effective incentive program or combination of programs for your company. Therefore, research and evaluation of incentive opportunities should be part of the business planning for the investment. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you got a useful overview of investment incentives in Germany and an impression of what different programs and measures can support your investment in details. Thank you very much for your attention.